A lot of people have asked, Mr. Champagne, who or what inspired you to become a teacher? That's a very fair question, and I thought about it for a long time. I think it all dates back to one summer when I was a camp counselor. It was in the Adirondacks in upstate New York. I was in charge of kids ages 10 to 12. It shaped the man who I am today. For example, when I say, no throwing rocks, I mean, no throwing rocks. And no spitballs means, yo, no spitballs. Because as you all know by now, I'm a pretty strict disciplinarian. Melissa was in fifth grade. She was 11 years old. She had short, dirty, blonde hair. She used to stand with her hands on her hips and say, I'm 68 and a half pounds. Her friends called her Missy. What I remember most about Missy is she would often wear this cream-colored sweatshirt. And printed on the back of this cream-colored sweatshirt was a picture of the planet Earth. And encompassing this picture of the planet Earth was a peace sign. And right below this picture of the planet Earth, encompassed by a peace symbol, was one word. Imagine. The boys seemed to have a certain reverence for Missy. She seemed to have an aura about her. Although I'm not necessarily saying that the boys had a crush on her, I noticed that unlike the other girls, they never once teased her. Something happened during that camp. I'm not sure why it happened, but I know the exact moment when it did. I was walking around the camp doing my counselor thing, when suddenly I heard in the background, freeze, and so I froze. And I waited until I heard a little giggle in the background and a unfreeze, and I continued on my way. And soon, a pattern started to develop. It didn't really matter what I was doing. Maybe I was tying my shoe. Freeze! And I would freeze. And again, I would wait for the giggles. Unfreeze, and I'd move around. And again, this game started to develop, but the game over time would establish new rules. Even though Missy had the ability to freeze me, I realized I also had the ability to freeze her. But unlike this fifth grader, no, I wasn't gonna waste my freeze. I was gonna wait for just the right moment. And late one morning, the kids were playing, and the clouds started to and it got darker and darker and darker and darker until I heard and felt a pat, 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 pat. It's raining! Get those kids inside. Let's go. It's raining. So as we were all going indoors, I turned and I looked at Missy, who was on her way, and I said, freeze. And in fairness, she froze. And I counted to 10, and I finally said, and I went inside. Oh, it was vicious, this game of freeze. Anyone who really knows me, especially in my morning classes, knows I love a good cup of coffee. And in the morning, I dare say, I need my coffee. And never more so than that week at camp. In the Adirondacks, even though it was summer, sometimes in the morning there's a damn chill. And I had to get my kids in the mess hall by 7 o'clock. So once they were situated, I went to this coffee pot just for counselors. And I remember, I got my mug and my saucer, and I pulled back on the spigot. And I watched that piping hot coffee pour out. And I grabbed my two sugars, my half and half, and my spoon. And I made my way, and I sat down to make my coffee. And remember, I took my two packets of sugar, and I ripped them open at the same time, because I'm a multitasker. And I poured my sugar into my coffee, and I saw the steam, and I would bathe myself in that aroma if I could. And then I took a little hat, and I poured that in as well, and I saw the black coffee begin to change color. And I took my spoon, and I started to stir my coffee. And freeze. Oh, no. And I looked up, and I saw these eyes staring at me with a slight smile on her face. And even though the only thing I wanted in this world was to drink my coffee, at this point I had to play the game because it was a battle of wills. And I watched how Missy gently pried the spoon from my forefinger and my thumb. And then she took the spoon and she stirred it in my coffee. And then she held up the spoon and she held it over my left arm, and I watched how hot drips of coffee dripped on my arm. And while she tried not to laugh, oh, I tried not to cry. Oh, it was vicious, this game called Freeze. And yet through it all, somehow, I even earned a nickname, Chicken Little. Now, I have been called many names in my life, but up to that point, Chicken Little was not one of them. Seemed wherever I would go, I would get taunted. I'd hear, oh, we'll go make soup out of you, Chicken Little. Oh, barbecue well done, Chicken Little. I was always looking over my shoulder. But then I had a thought, and I realized, of all the names I could be called, why Chicken Little? And so I asked Missy that specific question, and she really thought about it. I remember how she bit on her bottom lip just a little bit, and she smiled just a touch, and I knew she was debating whether she should tell me something or not. And then she finally looked up and she said, sometimes I call my dad Chicken Little, and sometimes you remind me. I was honored to be Missy's Chicken Little. Later on in that camp, one afternoon, something unfortunate occurred. It got really, really hot. It was humid, it was sticky, it was the kind of summer weather that can make you irritable. And a group of boys were playing kickball, and one boy slid into second base. He thought he was safe. Another kid said he was out. They started to argue, and the inevitable ensued. They started to fight. A couple punches were thrown. And then I was forced to do the one thing I hate most in this world. I yelled. I had to yell. Because those kids were fighting at camp, and everyone knows that you don't fight at camp! And so I took those kids to the head counselor, and I started walking back, and I started to reevaluate my behavior. As I said, I hate to yell. For whatever reason, it makes me feel ugly. And so I went to my students, and I checked on them to make sure they were okay. And I apologized for yelling. And one by one, I went to my kids until the last student I had was Missy. But I noticed that she was sitting and she had her head in her hands. And I remember I bent down and I said, Missy, I'm sorry, I yelled. I was wrong. And I remember how she looked up at me, and I could tell that she had. And she said, it's not you. It's not you. The fighting scares me. And I knew I had to ask another follow-up question, one I did not want to know the answer to. And I said, Missy, why does the fighting scare you? And she looked up at me again and she said, because my dad. On the last day at camp, when the kids were getting picked up and they were going home with their families, In the distance I heard, "Bye, Chicken Little." And I turned around and I saw Missy walking away, and she gently waved over her shoulder. And I noticed that as she walked on, she was walking away with her father. But as they walked off in the distance, I noticed that she kept looking up at her father, and he never once acknowledged his daughter. He kept looking straight ahead. All she wanted was his attention. I never saw Missy again, but the memory remains. Sometimes life is really hard. People enter in and leave our lives, and some of them leave this indelible impression, and we're left to make sense out of everything. We try to understand what it meant. I've often thought about what I would say to Missy if I had the chance to see her one more time. I like to think that she graduated from college. She's in her 20s, and she met someone who's really good to her. What I can't tell her, because I'm never going to get the chance. However, I can tell you, if I had the chance to see Melissa right here, right now, I would look her in the eyes and I would say, "You matter. You matter, and the world is a better place simply because you're in it. You matter. And if anyone ever tells you or treats you as otherwise, that person is wrong. You matter. I hope you will always believe in and work for a world that seeks to build and never destroys. Because anyone can destroy. It's the easy way out. Use your life to create something beautiful. It's time. There can be peace on earth. There can be peace on earth. Imagine. I love you. Thank you for your time. I love you. Thank you.